far away over the sea. There's a river that's calling to me. That river, she runs all around the place that I call my hometown. There's a valley on the side of the hill, and there's flowers on an old windowsill. A familiar old picture, it seems, and I'll go there tonight in my dreams, where it's green in the summer and gold in the fall. Her eyes are as blue as the sky I recall. Far away over the sea, there's a place at the table for me, where laughter and music abound, just waiting there in my hometown. Ah, the river, it freezes when there's snow on the ground, and the children can slide to the far side of town. Far away, me, hung up on a sweet memory. I'm lost and I wish I were found in the arms of my darling hometown. Far away over the sea, my heart is longing to be, and I wish I could lay myself down in the arms of my darling hometown. With the evening sun setting on top of the hill, and the mockingbird answering the old chapel bell. Far away me, hung upon a sweet memory. I'm lost and I wish I were found in the arms of my darling hometown. I'm lost and I wish I were found in the arms of my darling hometown.
That was a song from John Prine, who passed away some years ago. But he was a big part of our lives here in Ireland, considered very much part of one of our own. That was a song called My Darling Hometown. This next song I heard Sean Turrell singing many years ago in a little hall in Ballyleague near Lanesbury, County Longford. It's a song called The Green Eye of the Little Yellow God. It's a humorous sort of a song. Anyway, have a listen to it. It goes like this.
There's a one-eyed yellow idol to the north of Kathmandu. There's a little marble cross below the town. There's a broken-hearted woman tends the grave of Mad Guru, and the little yellow god forever gazes down. He was known as Mad Guru to the subs of Kathmandu, and he was hotter than they were inclined to tell. But for all his foolish pranks, he was worshipped in the ranks, and the colonel's daughter smiled on him as well. He loved her all along with a passion of the strong, and the fact that she loved him was plain to all. She was near 21 when arrangements were begun to celebrate her birthday with a ball. And He wrote and asked what present would she like from Mad Crew, and they met next day as he dismissed the squad. And jestingly she told him that the only thing to do would be the green eye of the little yellow god. It was the night before the dance. Akaroo seemed in a trance, and they chafed at him as they puffed on their cigars. But he never once did smile, he just sat there all the while, and then he walked out into the night beneath the stars. And it was dawn when he returned, with his shirt and tunic torn. There was a gash across his forehead, the ripping red. So they patched him right away, and he slept throughout the day, and the colonel's daughter watched beside his bed. And at last he awoke, he asked his tunic be sent through, and she brought it down and he thanked her with a nod. Then he better searched the pockets, saying that's from my crew. It was the green eye of the little yellow god. Ah, she operated my crew in the way that women do, though strangely both her eyes were hot and red. And she wouldn't take the stone, and Carew was left alone with a jewel that he had risked his life to get. Now the ball was at its height on that still and tropic night, and she thought of him and she hastened to his room. As she crossed the barrack square, she could hear the dreamy air of a waltz tune floating softly through the gloom. And the door was open wide, and the moon was shining through, and the floor was a wet and slippery where she trod. And an ugly knife lay buried in the heart of my crew. It was the vengeance of that little yellow god. There's a one-eyed yellow idol to the north of Kathmandu. There's a little marble cross below the town. There's a broken-hearted woman tends the grave of my crew, and the little yellow god forever gazes down. The little yellow god forever gazes down. And the little yellow god forever gazes down.
Thank you very much. That was a quirky little song. One that would make you afraid, nearly. But anyway, I learned this song years and years ago. I think it was in my parents' house when I was only maybe 10 or 12. And I've been singing it since. The Black family did a lovely version of it many years ago. It's a song called Colcannon. It just goes something like this. Did you ever make Colcannon made with lovely pickle cream, and the greens and scallions mingle like a picture in a dream? Did you ever make a hole on top to hold the melting flake of the creamy flavoured butter that our mothers used to make? Oh, you did, so did he, and so did I. And the more I think about it, sure, the nearer I'm to cry. Oh, weren't they the happy days when troubles we knew not, and our mothers made Colcannon in a little skillet pot? Oh, did you ever take potato cake or boxty to the school, tucked underneath your rockster with your books, your slate and rule? And when teacher wasn't looking, a great big bite you'd take of the creamy flavoured soft and melting sweet potato cake.
Oh, you did, so you did, so did he, and so did I. And the more I think about it, sure, the nearer I'm to cry. Oh, weren't they the happy days when troubles we knew not, and our mother's med calcanin in a little skillet pot? Oh, did you ever go a courtin' boys when the evening sun went down, and the moon began a peepin' from behind the hill of down? And you'd wander down a boreen where the Tlurocon was seen, and you'd whisper loving praises to your own dear sweet Colleen. Oh, you did, so did he, and so did I. And the more I think about it, sure, the nearer I'm to cry. Oh, weren't they the happy days when troubles we knew not, and our mother's med calcanin in a little skillet pot? Oh, you did, so did he, and so did I. And the more I think about it, sure, the nearer I'm to cry. Oh, weren't they the happy days when troubles we knew not, and our mother made Colcannon in a little skillet pot.
Thanks very much. This is a song I wrote with a good friend of ours who sadly passed not that long ago, a man called Frank Donnelly. Frank wrote the words and I wrote the melody. So we'll think about him this evening as well. So.
Can you see the snowflakes through your window? Two scenes of Christmas cards come to your mind. But there's no winter wonderland in cities where holly trees and robins are to find. Traffic oozing slowly through the evening, red steam screening drivers from our sight, heedless of the people on the pavement, spraying muddy slush from left to right. People shivering at the bus stops, children crying in their mother's arms, hope-filled eyes when each new bus approaches, sighing at successive false alarms. Police remove the homeless from the doorways in case they might offend the public view. But there are homeless shelters in this city where hundreds more are waiting in a queue. Shadows crowding dimly round a street lamp, curdling in the vagueness of the light. Terror in the hearts of lonely walkers, listening for those footsteps in the night. Was it always this way in the winter? Or is it just because we're growing old? Or are there scenes of beauty in this city if we only let our hearts and minds unfold? Can you hear the winter winds complaining, piling up the leaves of brown and gold? Can you feel the frosty fingers searching as we close our doors against the cold? Can you hear the winter winds complaining, piling up the leaves of brown and gold? Can you feel the frosty fingers searching as we close our doors against the cold?
Thank you very much. Thank you. Well, this is a very new song, only written, I think, recently. I'm not sure about the lyrics, but again, this was one that I wrote along with another poet and a Shanachie storyteller. His name is Vincent Pierce, originally from County Kerry, I think, but he's now settled and married with a nice family down in Roscommon. And Vincent wrote this as a poem and I put the melody to it. It's a lovely song called The Ballad of Mikey Carthy. I hope you like it.
Oh, my name is Mikey Carthy and I'm a travelling man. As many as the road I travelled with my horse and caravan. And me father was a tinsmith, a trade he passed to me. And it helped us make a living on the roads around Lochree. And me father owned a fiddle, and it was his pride and joy. And he taught to me a tune or two when I was just a boy. He told me to keep playing, it would be a friend to me. And it would help me make a living on the roads around Lochree. One evening I was travelling from Ballymahon town. And I met with Peter Carberry, that piper of renown. And he taught me drowsy Maggie and the birds upon the trees. And I played them tunes a thousand times on the roads around Lochree. And it was at the fair in Lanesborough where I first met Maggie Ward. And we were married 3 weeks later, and for that I thank the Lord. We raised a healthy family, and they were number 10 and 3. It was a struggle, but we managed on the roads around Lochree. How pleasant is in summer time to visit Lassen Town. Take a look across the lake just as the sun goes down. You can hear the cuckoos cuckooing and the birds sing merrily. It's the nearest place to heaven on the roads around Lochree. Akilteven and Knockrockery are always on my mind. And I miss the evening's fishing down in the River Hind. I'm settled now near Coosan, they say it's best for me. All I become redundant on the roads around Lochree. And now you've heard the story of this poor old travelling man, who struggled for a living with his horse and caravan. He's as honest as the days are long, and I'm sure you will agree that his likes we'll never see again on the roads around Lochree. He's as honest as the days are long, and I'm sure you will agree that his likes we'll never see again on the roads around Lochree.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Here's a song I learned from a good friend of mine, Jimmy Flanagan, and a song that was written by Mickey McConnell, a song called Supermarket Wine. You'd insist we chair the driving as we left those city lights in a clapped out Morris Minor heading west on Friday night, and the heater wasn't working and we never had a spare. Yet we called that old car Flattery, for it got us everywhere. And when we stopped to pitch the tent, it always seemed to rain. 'Tis then that I discovered you'd forgot the pegs again. And I couldn't get the campfire lit, no matter how I tried. Don't you remember? All them roadside stops for bread and cheese and supermarket wine. Oh, and the world was ours and I was yours, and I thought that you were mine. And you remember Galway races and your man in Harris Tweed, who, because he knew your father, he would do us a great deed. And the horse he put our money on, I'm sure 'tis running still. We were staying in a boarding house and we couldn't pay the bill. And you laughed when I went overboard and you told me not to swear. Ah, this town is full of Americans, we'll go busking in Air Square. And the Blarney Stone and the Leprechauns, they're bound to see us through. Don't you remember? As we sank the sun in Galway Bay for the 82nd time. Oh, when the world was ours and I was yours, and I thought that you were mine. And then you called me from the airport just before you caught your plane, and you told me you were leaving, but that I was not to blame. And you'd hoped that I might understand and that we could be good friends. Ah, but I knew by what you said that we would never meet again. And I must confess that it hurt like hell and that I miss you yet. For you are not the kind of girl 'tis easy to forget. And sometimes some half-forgotten fragment of you fills my mind, and I remember all them roadside stops for bread and cheese and supermarket wine. Oh, when the world was ours and I was yours, and I thought that you were mine. We had roadside stops for bread and cheese and supermarket wine. When the world was ours and I was yours, and I thought that you were mine. This next song I got from a good friend of mine in Dublin, Pat Hurley, many, many years ago, and I recorded it some years back, was Rig the Jig, on one of our albums. It's a song I love singing. It's called The Errant Apprentice. It goes something like this. When I was a young apprentice and less than compassmentous, I took leave of all my senses. With the maid I fell in love, her ringlet so entwined me, Aphrodite smiled, it blind me, Cupid's arrow struck behind me, and her father owned a pub. And it was there I met my nemesis, in her father's licensed premises, like the seraphim of Genesis, sat Mary Ann Maguire. Arrayed in fine apparel, astride a porter barrel, oh, she looked the sort of girl that would fill you with desire.
Oh, the turtle doves were cooing as I took to my wooing and her loveliness pursuing in the springtime of that year. But she thought I should be older and more gallant and much bolder in the uniform of a soldier. It's then she'd hold me dear. In extremis and euphoria, I joined with Queen Victoria for a spell of death or glory, a fighting with the boars. At the wind I threw all caution, I'll return with fame and fortune, and together make a portion of matrimony's choice. On the gravestone of her mother, she swore she loved no other, and I did soon discover that she had played me for a birk, or for lady luck had beached me, and intelligence had reached me, while I was overseas, that she had married to a Turk. Well, it was then that I deserted, to find the girl who flirted, back to Ireland I reverted, for me jealousy was roused, and in Maguire's pub in Derry, I found him making merry, with his arms around my Mary, as together they caroused. Oh, well, I took me time and waited, until his thirst had sated, as home he navigated through the streets of Derry town. At his lodgings he stood knocking, and while they were unlocking, I put a stone into a stocking, on his head I brought it down. And it was then the night's serenity was rant with loud obscenity, like Ottoman profanity, that I couldn't understand. Ah, with the note he made to grab me, with some intent to stab me, but as he tried to kebab me, I went screaming down the strand. All around the town's perimeter, he chased me with a scimitar, a big powerful passion limiter, to an earnest in his pride, and through the water side he chased me, to the bridge at Foyle he raced me, and at Derry Quay he faced me, so I jumped into the tide. Oh, now sure bravery is no virtue when some heathen's trying to hurt you, and all noble thoughts desert you when you see his curly knife. Ah, for there's many things worth trying for, occasionally worth lying for, but there's bugger all worth dying for, so I'll stick to the single life. Hello friend, I see you're a stranger, where do you come from? Hello friend, something in your face reminds me of the sun. But the northern light is thin against the darkness of your skin. Hello friend, I'm glad that you could come. When you talk, I hear the echoes of the places you have been. When you walk, colours all around you fluttering in the wind. When I listen to your song, I feel you really do belong. Am I the stranger, the one who's just come in? I think I know. What made you come here? What made you want to stay? Will you go? If the weather and the welcome seem too cold and grey, do you feel you'll ever find all the warmth you left behind? Never mind, I hope you want to stay. Did you find new friends to help you? Can you earn a living here? Do you mind the smoke and grime around you and the warning loud and clear? Or did your troubles just begin with the colour of your skin? Never mind, I'm glad to see you here. Did you come to climb a mountain or end up in a hole? Have you won the right to join our people signing on the dole? Can you be happy here amidst suspicion and the fear, or will you run and never more return? Hello, friend. All of us are strangers in this green and pleasant land once again. Battle ranks are forming and we need a brother's hand. Yours the fear and ours the shame, but our goal is just the same. In the end, this will be our native land.
This is one of my own songs that I wrote a couple of years ago. This is the first time I've recorded it. I regret that there's a shadow in my life. It walks along beside me day and night. An old flickering flame that I kindled in the past. She broke my heart and tore my world apart. Now I'm older and I regret some things I've done. Things you never see when you are young. I got caught up in the madness. I got caught up in the fun. I got knocked, but that lifeline didn't come. 'Cause I was drowning in the whiskey and the beer. Top shelf friend I had for many years. Have you got no homes to go to? Have you no one left who loves you? It's closing time and we're all going home. So if you fall in love with someone new, always keep them safe and close to you. Don't let the whiskey cloud your mind, for you'll regret it over time. And it will break your heart the same way it broke mine. 'Cause I was drowning in the whiskey and the beer. A top shelf friend I had for many years. Have you got no homes to go to? Have you no one left who loves you? It's closing time and we're all going home. Oh, it's closing time and we're all going home. Okay, this is the last song of the evening. It's a song from Brandy Carlile called Keep Your Heart Young. My granddaddy gave me a wheat penny and I kept it in my pocket. I had big plans in my backyard to build me a space rocket. I talked with my brother on a fake CB that I made from a tic-tac box. And I packed my snowballs nice and tight, and in the middle I put rocks. Oh, don't trade an ear in a tic-tac box for a ball at the end of a chain. Don't go spending grandpa's pennies buying into the game. You gotta keep your heart young. Oh, don't go growing old before your time has come. You can't take back you have done. You gotta keep your heart young. Daddy took the wheels off of my bike and he pushed me down the hill. I but speed got the best of me and I took my first spill. That was back when alcohol was only used on cuts. Oh, it stank like hell, so I jerked my leg and mama said it'd give me guts.
Oh, don't trade in your tic-tac box for a ball at the end of a chain. Don't go spending grandpa's pennies buying into the game. You gotta keep your heart young. Don't go growing old before your time has come. You can't take back what you have done. You gotta keep your heart young. Oh, you gotta keep your heart young. Don't go growing old before your time has come. You can't take back what you have done. You gotta keep your heart young. So take a picture of the one you love, put it in a locket. Go dig up that time capsule and the blueprint for your rocket. Stay in touch on that fake CB, the same old tic-tac box. Pack your snowballs a little less tight, but in the middle, still put rocks. Oh, don't trade in your tic-tac box for a ball at the end of a chain. Don't go spending grandpa's pennies, buying into the game. You gotta keep your heart young. Oh, don't go growing old before your time has come. You can't take back what you have done. You gotta keep your heart young. You can't take back what you have done is done. You gotta keep your heart young.
Thank you very much.